ela possa tomar ali. Opa! So, the stunt that Shatawale pulled, no, the stunt he pulled, no, it has had ripple effects. That doesn't mean what he did was right. Mo fe fi o. That doesn't mean what he did. Just the action and reaction. Shatawale said his main motive was to make sure that all these false prophecies stop. And fine, the means, yes, the end justifies the means, mom dear, but at this point, you know, IGP, this is what he's saying. So anybody who comes out to come and share in public, causing fear and panic, and no, you are going inside. And, oh, clap for IGP. Appa, appa. Yes. So the IGP met with the religious bodies, heads of the religious bodies, and they had a discussion. I have all the gist for you. I'm the headless YouTuber. This is Headless Reactions. Alatiare, Yanko! So this meeting that they had, Dr. George Ekufudampare, the IGP, presided at the meeting, which was attended by the members of the Police Management Board, representatives of the Christian Council of Ghana, Office of the Chief Imam, Ghana Catholic Bishop Conference, Pentecostal and Charismatic Council, every religious body, all the heads, everybody who matters. They were all there in the room to have a discussion with the police on religion and the law. Just a religion was fun, law also was fun, but they will all meet at some place. Your friend will be in the Venn diagram. Your friend will be Venn diagram. Just a way, but they meet somewhere, and that is where the IGP, he wanted them to discuss. Issues discussed included the provisions of the constitution relating to freedom of religion, the church or mosque as a corporate entity, criminal offenses that may be committed by religious bodies or their appointees, and also possible human rights abuses. Fine, we are seeing the church as a corporate body because more mojiska, yes, every Sunday mojiska. So yes, yeah, just say, and now they are saying they almost saying human rights abuses. We know that some of you know, yes, you do Sunday when you're going to church, you don't go with your brain. Yes. You see somebody going to church, say, hey, me if you come in the margin. And they'll go and leave their brain at home. And they'll go to church. That's how come some people can go and lie down for pastors to be lashing them. I saw this video, I was like, nothing. And pastors will be lashing them. So right now they are saying that there's a possible human rights abuse by the churches and the church and religious bodies and your church and mosque now they are the religious bodies. All these things, the police can get involved. Other issues discussed were spirituality and requirements of evidence as required by the courts, and also religious doctrines that contravene provisions of the constitution and the general enforcement of the law. At this point, I'm sure while they were sitting there, touch not my anointed was not part of the discussion. No matter who you are, Obeje. So this is what is happening. At this point, you can see all of them there. They were having a meeting with the IGP. And they told them that, hey, munim namo beshishan kom sa, those things you do, no? And right now we are in October, it's about to end, November, December. And we know what happens on 31st December. National Income Share Day. Yes. 31st night. That is when all the income share comes to pass. Yes. And this one will die. This one will die. Someone prophesied, I think, 3 or 4 years ago. Osu Bempa prophesied that Chief Imam will die. Up till now, the man is still alive. Bibi said, no. If now in the Dampare era, no, he will be dumb paralyzed. Which is because you can't come in Charlotte with somebody's age like that. Or they will be aged. Just say you see that the person is old. He's almost getting there. So you just predict that I'll create Michelle or Bill this year. And come Shannon, what they look to chat. So now the IGP is saying that, look, I'll put anybody who come and do your friend is saying, prophesying, then doom prophecies, no. All of you, you will go inside. I will deal with you. Until now, churches, all these religious bodies. Amunjineye. And I think this is good. And how does this relate to Shatawali? For so many years, people have been prophesying about Shatawali and other people. Ebony got her fair share and she's gone. When the Sheikh Rabai, she has also gotten some. Shatawali dear Bobo, Sakodia has gotten some. Just Obia. Anybody can eat banku and sleep and wake up and say, this person will die tomorrow or something. Then everybody will be just said, now it is fear and panic. Because all these stars, you know, they have fans, they have families. So if you come and do public, if you come and prophesy in public, you have to bring evidence. Because police, they are police, they deal with evidence. So if you come and prophesy in public that this person is about to die, bring evidence. Let's see the call that you did with God. What time did God call you? What time did God tell you this? Bring evidence. Let's see. Otherwise, so the best thing to do now, whoever it is, find the person's manager. If it's a public figure, an artist, find the person's manager. Talk to the person's manager. This is how you can avert it. Then, and you are gone. Remember, don't come and sit on radio because you want to episode GD. You want to be popular. And this is a very powerful man of God. He prophesied that this person will die and the person died. So you people cannot even prophesy that Manchester United, you're sure of 5-0. Anna, Holy Spirit, you know, share football. You people should give us odds. Prophesy odds. That way, you know, share, you get all the boys. This is a free tip to all the prophets out there. If you can be able to prophesy odds 3 times in a row, your church will be full. Amen. Because, but, share, here, boys, who? So all you need to do is prophesy odds. Forget all these celebrities and this person will die, you know. Prophesy odds. This is a free tip. Imagine a pastor just comes and says, okay, this team will win. 3 times in a row, you trap 13 odds, 15 odds, maybe. Sunday. Yeah, better you will say, yeah, the money. And so this is the issue on the ground. You say, IGP will deal with all these people, all these doomed prophets who come and prophesy in public. And also they had a meeting and these are the kind of things they discussed. So if your pastor has not heard it yet, send this video to him. And I don't know, keep subscribing, keep sharing. Yaden, yapong.